In this video, I'm going to talk about a company with rock-solid fundamentals, who pays a dividend, who has got good growth, and also has an incredible competitive advantage in the market. And this company, I feel, is also undervalued at the moment. So the company I'm going to talk about today is American Express. And American Express have been on my watch list actually for quite some time now. Now, as we know, last week we saw a big sell-off in the markets due to the new COVID variant that came out. And funny enough, this COVID variant actually comes from my home country, which is South Africa. But anyway, there was a big sell-off, and one of the companies that are feeling this sell-off is American Express, and they are down about 9.7% in the last 5 days. So why do I love American Express so much, and why exactly do they have such a great moat? And the reason for that is that American Express is quite different from MasterCard and Visa. An American Express cardholder spends about 2 to 5 times more than the average Visa or MasterCard user. So for that reason, they actually charge higher fees to the banks. They also charge higher fees to the merchant. And the reason they can do that, well, is because of the incredible purchasing power behind the customer that holds the American Express card. So if you have a shop and you have an American Express person coming into your shop, you know that they will most likely spend a lot more than the person who owns a Visa or a MasterCard card. So for that reason, they have an incredible competitive advantage in the market. And that's also why I love American Express so much. So with that being said, let's go check out the stock and see what actually happened with this stock. Now, as you can see, in the last 5 days, this stock is down 9.7%. If we zoom out to the last year, you will see this massive drop here. And as you can see, it's still up 32%. And in the last 5 years, you will see that massive dip in 2020. And that was because of people just not traveling anymore. And of course, American Express was hit really hard by COVID and people didn't spend that much on their credit cards anymore. But have a look at this PE ratio at the moment, sitting at 16.4. If you compare that with Visa, Visa has a PE ratio of 39.7. MasterCard, on the other hand, also has a PE ratio of 39.8. American Express, once again, only sitting with a PE ratio of 16.4. They also pay out a dividend of 1.1%. If you look at Visa, the dividend is sitting at 0.76. And then the dividend for MasterCard is 0.54. So let's go check out the stock and then do a fundamental analysis on them. And then you will see why I love American Express so much. So looking at the overview of the stock first, you will see that the stock is currently trading under the ticker AXP. And they've got a market cap of $121.4 billion. Now the price 10 years ago was sitting at $50.37. And the price today is actually sitting at $156.82. And by the way, Warren Buffett actually also owns this stock. Now the PE ratio currently sitting at 16.38, so not excessive at all. Like I said, it looks a lot better than Visa and MasterCard. The net margin also looking really good, sitting at 18.9%. And what is interesting about American Express as well, while they've got such an incredible advantage, is they actually offer a lot better rewards to their customers than the competitors. And the reason they can do that is, of course, because they charge higher fees to the merchants and the banks. So that's another thing I love. They also pass the savings on to the customer. So then looking at the net equity, currently sitting at $22.9 billion. The equity to market cap currently sitting at 18.92. Generally, our benchmark is 10%. And then as we know, they pay a dividend of 1.1%. The payout ratio only makes up 18.04% of the total earnings. Now, the total dividends that they pay out to the shareholders currently sitting at $1.3 billion. The free cash flow currently sitting at $11.6 billion, which means that if you subtract the dividend from the free cash flows, they are still left with cash flows of $10.2 billion. So as you can see, this company is just printing cash at the moment. So now let's go check out some of the key ratios of this stock. So currently the debt to equity ratio is pretty high, sitting at 150.57%. Generally, my benchmark is 40% or less. However, if you look at MasterCard on the other hand, the debt to equity ratio for MasterCard is sitting at 200%. So it looks like for the industry, the debt to equity ratios are just pretty high. Then looking at the free cash flow to debt sitting at 7%, the price to sales currently sitting at 3.41. The price to book sitting at 5.44, and the 5-year beta sitting at 1.22. Now the total shares held by the insiders for American Express sitting at 0.1%, and the total shares held by the institutions sitting at 84.95. So as you can see, there are a lot of institutions holding this stock at the moment. Now, the percentage of shares that are shorted at the moment sitting at only 1.51, so very little. The short ratio is sitting at 3.63. And then I love looking at the return on equity because this shows me how the management is retaining equity within their own company. Generally for this, I have a benchmark of 10%. And the reason for this is I'd like to see growth. And anything above 10% means that there is good equity growth within the company. So for American Express, it's sitting at 33.61%. That is really, really good. Looking at the return on assets, sitting at 4.19. And then I love looking at the return on invested capital as well, because this shows me how the management is investing the capital for the company. And this generally comes back to the shareholders, that along with the dividend as well. What I like to see here is they are sitting with a return on invested capital of 11.4%. Generally, my benchmark is 10%. Now, the current ratio is sitting at 1.59. This means that they have got more current assets than current liabilities. Now, if you don't know what current assets and current liabilities are, current assets are assets that can be converted into cash within the next 12 months. Current liabilities are liabilities that are payable within the next 12 months. So it's only logical that your current assets needs to be higher than your current liabilities. And for that to happen, the current ratio needs to be 1 or greater than 1. In this case, as you can see, it definitely is. Now the revenue compounded annual growth sitting at 1.09, and I will tell you why this is pretty low. So the operating cash flows have been growing by 10.13% compounded annual growth. The free cash flows 11.13%, and the earnings per share only sitting at 4.91 compounded annual growth over the last 3 years. And now you will see why this happened if you look at the year-on-year data. So as you can see, the red means numbers are declining. And as you can see, basically all of the numbers have been declining in 2020, and that was due to COVID. Obviously, people couldn't go out, people weren't traveling anymore, and people were not spending on their American Express cards. So American Express is just one of these companies that have been hit really hard by COVID. But have a look at the numbers, and then have a look at the numbers in the trailing 12 months. As you can see, there has been a massive, massive recovery for American Express. And that's also why you have been seeing the stock price going up, is because of the recovery. But now the first thing we look at is the shares outstanding to see if there's any shareholder dilution taking place. In this case, they've actually been buying back their own shares. So for the current shareholders, that's actually a good thing. They are being rewarded in this way. Now the current assets still up from 188 billion all the way up to 191 billion. As you can see, the current assets are definitely more than the current liabilities. The total equity is basically still the same than 3 years ago, but to be fair, COVID really wasn't good on them. But looking at the total revenue, you can see a big recovery in the trailing 12 months. The same with the gross profit, the operating income, the net income, the operating cash flows, and the free cash flows, as well as the earnings per share. As you can see, earnings per share also up from 3 years ago, where it was sitting at 7.91, now sitting at 9.58. So as people get vaccinated and people start traveling again, then you will definitely see the numbers increasing a lot. When that will happen, I absolutely just don't know, because as we've seen, a new variant has been detected in South Africa, and a lot of investors are obviously scared about what's going to happen with that. However, on this channel, we look at long-term investing and not the short-term. Anyway, moving on to my 18-point checklist. I'm now going to take everything I looked at and then score it down in my 18-point checklist, which is divided up into 3 different segments: the fundamentals, the momentum, and then the growth. So looking at the fundamentals first, the PE ratio is between 1 and 25. The net margin definitely greater than 10%. Now the total assets are greater than the liabilities. The dividend cost is also less than the free cash flow. The debt to equity ratio, unfortunately, not less than 40%. The current ratio is greater than 1, and the shareholders have not been diluted in the last 3 years. Which now takes us over to the momentum questions. Now what you will see here is the revenue, the gross profit, the operating income, the net income, the operating cash flows, and the free cash flows, none of them have been growing year on year. So unfortunately, they didn't score any points for the momentum. But that's also understandable if you look at this. As you can see, there has been growth in almost every single one of those metrics. However, in 2020, there was a decline in every single one of those metrics. So if it wasn't for 2020, you would probably be seeing year-on-year growth for American Express. Anyway, moving on to the growth questions. The share price have definitely doubled in the last 10 years. The return on equity is greater than 10%. Unfortunately, the return on assets not. The return on invested capital also greater than 10%. And unfortunately, the earnings per share have not been growing by a compounded annual growth rate of 10% in the last 3 years. And that was once again due to COVID. So now we are going to do two different valuation models, a free cash flow model, and then also an earnings per share model to see what the fair valuation is for this company. So looking at the free cash flow first, you will see that currently the price to free cash flow is sitting at 10.45. So what I did was I took three different scenarios, a low, a medium, and then a high. So on a low, I said I would be paying 8, and then on a median, I said 12, and then the multiple on the high sitting at 15. And I got this by looking at the historical data for American Express, which gives you a low price of $115, a median price of $173, and a high price of $217, which means that it's an average price of $168 for the fair valuation if you look at the free cash flow model. And if you look at today's price, it's sitting at $156. So it's definitely undervalued if you compare it to the free cash flow model. Moving on to the earnings per share model, you will see the first thing is the discount rate. That's the return on my investment that I want to see. And this is sitting at 10%. You can play around with it. You can add your own one. But I took three different scenarios here as well. Well, that's basically three different growth projections, a bear case, a median case, and then a bull case. So I looked at what the analysts are predicting, and I looked at some of the historical data, and I decided to be pretty conservative on it. And I believe actually that this is pretty conservative numbers. So on the bear case, I said that we're growing at 6%, on the median case, 7%, and on the bull case, sitting at 9%, with a fair target PE ratio of 15, which I also feel is pretty conservative for American Express. But this will give you a bear case of $153, a median case of $158, and a bull case of $168, which means that it's an average price of $160, which is the fair price for today if you want to see a return on your investment of about 10% year on year. And keep in mind they also still pay out a dividend as well. So this brings me over to my verdict and what I think about the stock. Obviously, I feel that it's undervalued because that is also the title of this video. And like I said, this company have been on my watch list for quite a while now. But if you want to learn how to analyze stocks like us, you can head over to our website where you can get access to all of our courses absolutely free of charge. You can also get access to the two different valuation models. It's a free spreadsheet that you can download and you can play around with your own numbers. So with that being said, let's go check out the verdict. So if the fundamentals sitting at 86%, so as you can see, the fundamentals looking absolutely great. However, they didn't score anything on the momentum side, and that was due to COVID. Then looking at the growth sitting at 60%, so also doing very well there. The analyst 12-month target is $189. And if you look at the analyst breakdown, you will see that they are bullish on the stock, rating at 3.61 out of 5. 6 being very bullish, 5 being bullish, 14 being neutral, and then 1 being bearish. If we scroll down, we will see that the 12-month target is sitting at an average of $189.35 with a high of $233 and a low of $151. And keep in mind, currently this stock is trading at $156. So then if we go back to my verdict, as you see, my price projection sitting at around $160, which means that it's a potential gain of $3.19 or a net margin of 2.04%. So obviously, I feel that this stock is a buy. I like the fact that they've got a very competitive advantage in the market as well. I also love the fact that the average American Express user pays around 2 to 4 times more than the average Visa or MasterCard user. So for that reason, I love American Express. I think that it's trading at a very fair price at the moment. And keeping in mind, my valuation models didn't even include the dividend as well. So let me know in the comments below, do you think I was a little bit too conservative with my projection models? Obviously, I like to be on the conservative side. And if you look at some of the analyst estimates, some of them actually predict that American Express will be growing by around 30% over the next 5 years. But I also know that the analysts are a little bit too optimistic at some times. So if you want to see more stocks that we feel are undervalued at the moment, simply click on the link coming up in this video right now.